Today we're going to talk about something really interesting and important. The theory of evolution. Now, I know some of you might be thinking, oh no, not another science lesson. But trust me, this is something that is actually super cool and relevant to our lives. And don't worry, we'll make it fun and easy to understand. So what is evolution? Before Darwin, people had lots of different ideas about how living things came to be. Some people believed that everything was created exactly as it is now, while others thought that animals could spontaneously generate from non-living matter. Can you even imagine that? But then, in the mid-1800s, a guy named Charles Darwin came along and changed everything. He proposed the idea of natural selection, which is the process by which certain traits become more common in a population over time, because they help the organisms that have them survive and reproduce better. Darwin's theory was groundbreaking, but it was also controversial. People had a hard time accepting that we all evolved from apes. But over time, more and more evidence has been found to support the theory of evolution, and it is now widely accepted by the scientific community. But it's not just Darwin's work that has contributed to our understanding of evolution. There have been many other scientists who have made important discoveries and contributed to the theory. And today, researchers are still learning more about how evolution works and how it has shaped the world we live in. So there you have it, a brief history of the theory of evolution. Let's talk about the evidence that supports the theory. One kind of evidence is the fossil record. Fossils are the remains of organisms that lived in the past, and they can tell us a lot about how life on Earth has changed over time. Scientists have found fossils of all kinds of organisms, from dinosaurs to early humans, and they have been able to piece together a picture of how these organisms evolved and adapted to their environments. Another kind of evidence is comparative anatomy and physiology. This is the study of the similarities and differences in the structure and function of different organisms. By comparing the anatomy and physiology of different species, scientists have been able to show how they are related and how they have evolved over time. Finally, there is molecular biology, which is the study of the molecules that make up living things. By comparing the DNA of different species, scientists have been able to show how they are related and how they have evolved over time. So there you have it. The evidence for evolution. Now that we're familiar with the evidence supporting the theory of evolution, let's delve into some of the controversies it has sparked. One kind of controversy is religious objections. Some people believe that evolution goes against their religious beliefs, and they argue that the theory is wrong. Another kind of controversy is alternative theories. While the theory of evolution is widely accepted by the scientific community, there are some people who propose alternative explanations for how life on Earth came to be. Some people misunderstand how the theory works or think that it means certain things that it doesn't. For example, some people think that evolution means that humans are better than other species, or that it means that life has no purpose. Given the controversies that surround the theory of evolution, it's crucial to understand its importance. Let's delve into some of the reasons why. First of all, understanding evolution has all kinds of implications for biology and medicine. For example, evolution can help us understand why some diseases are more common in certain populations, and it can help us develop new treatments and therapies. Second, understanding evolution helps us understand the natural world. It helps us make sense of the diversity of life on Earth and how different species are related. It also helps us understand how living things have adapted to their environments, and how they will continue to change in the future. Understanding evolution has implications for society and culture. It can help us understand how different cultures have developed, and how they are related. And it can also help us understand how humans fit into the natural world. But the story of evolution doesn't end here. If you enjoyed this discussion and want to learn more about evolution and other scientific topics, make sure to hit the subscribe button. I'll be posting more videos like this one, and I'd love to have you along for the journey. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.